Good evening. Thank you so much for inviting me to your event tonight. Unfortunately, we're here at the Capitol passing bills off the floor of your state capitol, so I can't be there. But I have my good friend, Representative Sharon Tomiko Santos, who's the chair of the Financial Education Public-Private Partnership, along with me to help explain what's going on in our state around financial education. Sharon?
Thank you so much, Marcus. You know, our state is just now beginning to see some signs of recovery after the Great Recession, but still thousands of our fellow Washingtonians are experiencing great financial challenges and hardships. And that's why it underscores the need for our work in financial education to ensure that our young people today are equipped with the skills and knowledge to become financially capable adults.
That's right, Sharon. I think we really have to be proactive, and we're taking trainings across our state and making sure that it's embedded in the curriculum to make sure that our students graduate in a self-sufficient manner so that they're ready to move forward and make good financial decisions.
Absolutely. Spent Looking for Change, I think, is one of those movies that just gives us great insight into the day-to-day struggles that our fellow Americans face. A little education can go a long way, and we've seen it over and over again in the types of trainings that we offer.
Yeah, I was surprised, actually shocked to learn that folks could accumulate up to $40,000 worth of extra debt if they don't bank at traditional financial institutions. So this is a kind of education that seems to be very effective and also put real money in real people's pockets. So I really want to thank Representative Santos for coming and shedding some light on financial education. And I want to thank you for all the work that you're doing on financial education. I've got to get back in there and vote on some more bills, but I hope you have a great event and a great evening, and keep up the commitment towards making sure that we have financial education across our state for our youngest learners as we move forward and for our families. Thank you.